Mr. Excel Podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learning Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 1441, Conditional Format the Entire Row. Well, today's question is sent in by Amal. Amal has a data set, and he has a couple things that he wants to check for. He wants to see if the status is not true, or X or Y or something, and also if the due date is within 14 days of today. So I decided I was going to try and puzzle this out before I went into the conditional formatting. Equal and. First thing, I want to note the not function, that this is equal to true. Now, if it was just true false, it would be simple enough, but you know, he might be using in parentheses a Y or whatever he's using to mark it. In my case, I use true to mark it. So we want that to be true. Also, we want the date, so that's E2, to be less than, in parentheses, today, plus 14, or maybe 13, depending on if you know, you're counting, how you count 2 weeks. And that closes the and. We'll copy that down, and you'll see that just these two items, which are due soon, are marked as true. Now, I need to go back and edit this formula and add some dollar signs in. I always needed to point to column D, and I always needed to point to column E, because in essence, what I'm going to be doing, it's like I'm going to be taking that formula and copying it on top of this whole range. So I need to always lock that down to column D, but the row needs to be able to change, 2, 3, 4, 5, and so on. So I'm going to copy that to the clipboard, Control C. I'm going to choose, starting here in cell A2, the whole data set, and then Alt-O-D for conditional formatting. New rule, I want to use a formula. That's the only one that's going to work here. And just paste. Format, he said he wanted it highlighted in red, so we'll use a nice red color there. Click OK, click OK, click OK, and check that out. It formats the whole record in the database. Formula is, or using that formula, is really the only way to format a cell looking at some other cell in that row. And again, it's easier to build it out here first and get it working, and then go into conditional formatting. All right, well, hey, I want to thank them all for sending that question in. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.